The official podcast of the waterfront capital of Texas.
We running this. Let's go. I'm on a boat.
Everybody look at me because I'm sailing on a boat.
Weekends on the Water with Jordan Davlin of Jet Surf Houston and Scene Magazine publisher John Ennis.
That is right. This is Weekends on the Water, and we're back coming to you live from the Jet Surf Houston studio along the north shore of Clear Lake in the heart of the waterfront capital of Texas. A special thanks to Raz Halili of Pier 6 Seafood and Prestige Oysters for hosting us last week at his beautiful facility. If you missed last week's show, definitely give a listen to it. And if you haven't been to Pier 6 Seafood along the San Leon coast overlooking Galveston Bay, I don't know what you were waiting for.
Oh, man.
Man, check it out. But as always, my name is John Ennis, and I'm joined by Army veteran, extreme water sports competitor, and Jet Surf Houston founder, Jordan Davlin. How goes it, Jordan?
Yo, yo, yo. What's going on, man?
Man, today, I declared today the most beautiful day of the year to date.
Yeah,
today. I don't know. Maybe not, but that's my story, and I'm sticking to
either
it.
Either yesterday or today. It's one of the two.
It's been
amazing.
This is why we live along the waterfront capital of Texas, right here.
Getting a taste of it, yeah.
Beautiful days. I mean, and right now, literally, we're looking at a gorgeous sunset across Clear Lake with the Nassau Bay Hilton in the background. I mean, this is what it's all about, man. This is my favorite month of the year. I say that every March. Of course, every October, I usually say October is my favorite month. But between October and March, I'm putting March in the lead right now.
Yeah, absolutely. I guess that brings us to this episode talking about all the amazing new fun activities and just the water community. We have an awesome guest tonight.
Woo-hoo!
I'm proud to announce John Stapleton, the founder and CEO of Upper Coast and Naughty Nation.
Hey, what's going on, everybody?
What's
up,
man?
Yeah, what's up, John?
How are you doing tonight?
Doing good. Appreciate y'all having us out tonight.
Yeah, man. No, this
representing.
Is a special episode for us. We are we're happy to you know, get with you on this episode, man, and just talk about all the things that we got going on. So John is another cheerleader of the water and someone that's trying to promote the community out there and get people out having fun. So yeah, man, we're super excited to have you on the show.
Yeah, no, hey, I appreciate it, and didn't grow up on the water, but always loved it, and I always knew that I would end up here.
Yeah.
I got here quicker than I thought I would, so, man, it's been great, and I jumped in the deep end with it all, and absolutely loving every day of it.
Yeah, yeah.
That's awesome. So, yeah, it doesn't matter, if you grew up with it, it matters that you get to the water eventually, right?
That's right.
And credit to you, man, because, you mentioned you're relatively new to the area, and you're already shaking stuff up, man.
We're trying. So, we got going with – so Upper Coast is our company, and really what's more important is our community, which is called Naughty Nation.
Right, right.
And so, people that know me probably get tired of hearing this phrase that I say.
Never.
But – Steve Jobs quoted, you can't connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. And I believe that 100%. And when I look at where the Naughty Nation is today, we're over 3,000 strong. We're growing, 100 to 200 plus every week in our community.
Yeah, of course.
We're going to be hitting some, big numbers here. In the coming years, we're really focused on, the whole Gulf Coast, and I grew up coming down to the Gulf Coast vacationing and what have you, and I just wanted to spread that love of the Gulf Coast.
Yeah,
I really did. So everywhere from SPI all the way around to Key West, we had family in the Houston area, so that made sense to make home port for us, if you will.
Yeah.
And it's been great. We moved down here, my wife and our family. We moved down here about a year and a half ago, and just kind of started. Like I said, can't connect the dots unless you look backwards. It's just started a Facebook group. Really,
yeah.
It's kind of how it started. It wasn't even called the Naughty Nation back then. Just started it as fun. When we moved down here, I wanted to find a group or a. Something to get associated with. I just couldn't find anything that really spoke to me. So I was like, well, heck, I'm just going to create something.
Nice.
So
just got to go for it.
Yeah. So, you know, we started this Facebook group, and it started growing and growing and growing. People started private messaging me,
yeah.
You know, hey, we love what you're doing. We love what you're doing. And so I was like, hey, you know what? We need to put a name to this. And so actually it was a public polling of the group at the time. And so Naughty Nation was top of the list.
What y'all came up with,
huh? Which is nice. Yeah, yeah, that works, awesome. Man. Yeah, that works. Know, yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah.
I like the alliteration.
Oh yeah. Heck yeah.
And so I always say we're just naughty enough, you know?
Yeah.
And so, you know, really what I wanted to do was just create a community of people that were like-minded, that loved the water, that loved the lifestyle. You know, it wasn't super hardcore fishing. It wasn't super hardcore, you know, the different aspects of the saltwater life.
Boat racing. Yeah.
It was just everything. And even just the relaxed, you know, laid-back lifestyle of Gulf Coast,
the beach, the pool, yeah,
absolutely. Yeah. And so, I mean, you know, the idea of it really caught on, and so then I started thinking, okay, you know what, you know, okay, I've got this growing community. I want to do more for this community than just have a Facebook group. And so I was like, okay, well, you know, what can I do to give back to this community? And so I created an actual company called Upper Coast. Which is an actual LLC at this point. And so I'm developing things like a VIP program. I'm actually coming out with, I'm a glutton for punishment. So, this is my early, you know, this is my 4:30, 5 in the morning and 10 o'clock at night thing and a weekend thing. But I'm coming out with a video magazine.
Yeah. Okay. That's very cool.
So, you know, kind of taking the old school print, but putting today's content absorption to that.
Sure.
So coming out with a video magazine that, again, you know, goes from SPI all the way around to Key West. And, you know, just trying to give back to the community as much as I can. Part of that VIP, you know, we're creating this VIP program. Part of that also includes I'm working with, you know, different businesses and trying to partner with different businesses to say, hey, you know what? I will help promote your local, you know, coastal business so long as you give our VIP community a some sort of a incentive or a discount or what have you.
Right, yeah.
And
invited to certain private parties they're having or, you know, so cool stuff.
Absolutely. So, you know, I'm trying to give back to that community as much as I can. And then another thing that was like super important for me was I wanted it to grow and evolve beyond online. You know, online's great, but, you know, it's really real when you can reach out and touch something.
Yeah, when you're actually capturing the content or the people, the community is actually capturing it. They're living out there. And
absolutely.
Doing it, yeah.
So I was like, okay, let's start doing events. Like, let's do like actual Naughty Nation events. So we've done a couple of local events here in the Clear Lake area. We're going to do a Naughty Nation summer kickoff event, which will actually be a boat raft up.
Yeah, man. I'm super excited about
that.
We're
going to have you guys out doing some demos out there for us. So we're excited about that. So that's May 21st. It's going to be a raft up out in Galveston Bay at Redfish Island.
Yep, Redfish Island, guys. Yeah, mark your calendars.
Yep, May 21st. And then I just got locked in. Super excited about this, too. Because not everyone has boats, but yet I know a lot of people want to be able to come to the events.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, we need to do some stuff other than just boat events. So,
other than just islands, you got you know, maybe some marina action in there.
Yes,
you know, land and sea.
Yeah. So I actually got confirmation this week that I'm locked in for a event in August. I believe it's August 13th. I'll have to double check the date, but I believe it's August 13th. We're going to do a an end of summer beach party.
Yeah.
So that's going to be at the Beachfront Bar and Grill down in
San Leon.
In Surfside.
Surfside.
So very cool. They have an awesome venue out there. It's right on the beach. It's the best place to have a party.
Yeah.
And so we've got both events. We have Blue Chair Bay Rum. And we have Palapa Mac Radio that'll both be at those events with us.
Yeah.
So that'll kick off our 2022 season, our 2022 year. My goal is to be able to take the parties and move them around the Gulf Coast.
Sure.
So, nice. You know, my hope is that, you know, next year, you know, maybe we're doing some stuff in Orange Beach.
Right.
You know, maybe in 2024, we're doing some stuff over in Destin, Pensacola, maybe down around in the Keys.
A lot going on in the Gulf. They don't realize how many amazing destinations. You know, we've got this awesome spot right here in our backyard, but there's so much. Yeah, like you said, from SPI all the way to Key West.
Absolutely.
It's ridiculous. So,
absolutely. Yeah. You know, I mean, I've been to the East Coast. I've been to the West Coast. I haven't done a lot of international travel, but, you know, I've hit – you know, everywhere in the U.S. And man, there's just something about the Gulf Coast that it's just awesome.
Third Coast, right?
Yeah, absolutely. it really is. It's awesome. And you know, just want to spread the love of that to the community.
Excellent.
Yeah. Nice.
I mean, like you said, I love what you're doing because you don't have to necessarily live by the water or live on the water to enjoy the water. You're trying to promote people that are involved in the water or not involved in the water to feel comfortable coming from, whether it's Waco, coming down to enjoy for the weekend or for a particular event. Like I said, you're promoting and spreading the word kind of like we do to try to get anybody and everybody involved. And there's just so many things people don't realize that you can do water related. It's amazing.
Well, let's face it, man, the third coast, or we'll call it the upper coast. I mean, it's the playground for middle America, right? Yep. I mean, it's people.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I can't tell you how many times back when we had the office over at Sasha Harbor Marina, how many times I'd meet people from Oklahoma City, from Kansas, from Nevada that all have their boats docked here.
Yeah,
I mean, this is a playground for people from all over America to come in. It's really a destination. So, and of course, you know, I love that you're taking it, you know, I mean, the entire Gulf Coast. I mean, I grew up going to Gulf Shores, Alabama every summer to meet my grandparents, right? I mean, just so many fond memories of the Alabama coast and Pensacola and all that.
I'm a big Destin guy,
the White Sands.
Naples. And the water my sister was born in Fort Myers. I mean, you know, yeah, like I've lived in Florida for years. I mean, it's, I love that you're taking it down the whole coast. There's so much to offer, so many, and every one of those little, not little, but those towns has something different to offer.
True,
you know, yeah. So it's whether it's the watercolors, the restaurants, the vibes. I mean, certain events going on certain times of the year, boat races in Key West. You know, spring break in Panama City, Destin, Florida, with summer. Just the oh my gosh, what is the what's that area that they go out to? Something, it's not an island. They call it
Crab Island.
I guess it is Crab
out,
Island.
Out around Destin.
Island. Man, so there's Jet Surf Destin guys out there, and that is an awesome spot for them. That's very cool out
yes.
there.
Yes. Yeah. So. Yeah. You know, and you're right. There are. There's so many cool places along the Gulf, and they all have their own unique things to offer.
Right.
This area here
Has the most to offer. officially.
No. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. The Texas upper coast is amazing. And, I don't know that I would want to live anywhere else, but I love the whole Gulf Coast and I want to support all of that. And all the businesses and like you said, you know, we've got people, you know, inland, and always, you know, I like to call them inland saltaholics. So, you know, there's tons of inland saltaholics that love to come down, and anything that we can do to help, you know, bring them into the lifestyle and help them enjoy, you know, what the coast has to offer. That's what I hope to do. Along with, you know, helping those that actually do live here, you know, the residents of the coast, as well as supporting the local businesses.
Yeah, like you said, it's a community, and you know, just because you own a boat or live on the water, maybe you're not tied.